We're looking at the apps that I have installed, and I made a list here. So I installed Chrome, Notepad++, Versus Studio Code, VLC, Discord, Rerun Installer, Steam, and PyCharm. Kinda makes sense. You can see all of the things I have installed here. Boom, 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 boom. This little thing here is an app I just made for the fun of it that I use to monitor some stuff when it's working, actually, you know. And yeah, I also, of course, installed OBS so I can, you know, record stuff. So if you go in here, we can do a little bit of OBS inception. And of course, we have PyCharm, Versus Studio Code, Discord, VLC, and all of these seems to be working quite well. I don't want to open up my coding software at the moment because I need to still set them up. I haven't set them up, I just have installed them. And if you go in and look at my little thing here, I modified the menu. I don't have recommended, I don't like it, I don't need it. I do like it this, however, having this pinned up here. And yes, I have Spotify up here, and I actually use quite a few of these tools here, even Edge, which some people really don't believe that I do. I will scroll down here and you can look at my list here of things that are installed. Yep, I also installed Minecraft just to check it out, and actually runs Minecraft really well. I still need to set up OneNote for work and stuff like that. I installed PowerShell, and that's like, this is the bare minimum I need to basically do what I need to do. And you may wonder, what is this Revo uninstall? And it's probably one of the best, in my humble opinion, uninstaller you can use for free. I've used this for years now. I can't even remember how long I've been using it. I probably should upgrade to the pro version just to give them some money from all of the amazingness that they have brought to me. But it's really, really simple way of uninstalling software. So what you want to do is you just go in here. I don't know, can we have some games on here also? So we go in here and then you click uninstall, and it asks you to set up a restore point. You can do that if you want to. It uses the program's default uninstaller. Uninstall it, then it looks at the registry, and then it looks at the file system to see if there's any leftovers. If there is, it asks you to delete it. At your choosing, you can select which part of it you want to delete, what files and stuff like that. And Bob's your uncle, you are set to go. I don't want to go into each and individual little program here, which we could open up Microsoft Edge here. You can see what my start page looked like. You see a lot of my things that I used to go to the most in my bookmark bar and what have you not. And from the program I've run, the things I've done with it so far, I really, really do enjoy it. I did upgrade to a 1 TB SSD, NVMe SSD, from 250. I had to buy a new fan. That's like, I think like $30 from Dell or something like that. So with all of these upgrades, yeah, it's kind of, you know, what you would pay for a working laptop like this. I just happened to get this real cheap. I didn't know the fan was wrong, and I knew that I just would have bought a more expensive one and not deal with that myself. I really like it. The other thing that is a little bit irritating, the battery, it's not the best. I get like about, without gaming, I may get 2.5 hours out of it. With gaming, tested some Minecraft, I may get about 2 hours out of it. So I may need to replace it. I haven't tested it with, what is it called, just web browsing. I haven't tested that out yet. Maybe I should do that. With only web browsing, I probably could get about 2 to 2.5 hours with no video playbacks. I don't know. But I am looking into batteries. They're not super expensive either, but I don't really need it because I'm not taking this with me in places where I need to be mobile, so to speak, like run around with it unplugged. Or if I do, it's not that much anyway. See you all later. Bye-bye.